What is the next step? I have wound my springs for the lift as described by Mr. Keshe last week and placing the three wire springs 120 degrees apart. I would like to know what the next step is.
Next step, you need one in the middle.
Okay.
You need a four. Until you don't have the four reactors, you can't enforce the closure.
And would the new design include some sort of plate assembly in between the top reactor?
No, you don't really need a plate assembly. We're trying to, at the moment we're in a transition point, you need the, what do you call it, the central plate. But what you will see is that the center core will move up itself, and the, as I said, the three reactor cores in the 120 degree move down. It's, you see what we have here is very much, if we say we have the six as a center, this to be our center core, you have this reactor moving up. If you look at it, the shape will be this reactor here is connected to the motor. This reactor will move up. This is your gravitational ring. The magnetical ring, which sits somewhere here, if you can extend it in a different way, if you look at it, this is your center, and your, this is your, the three base. So what happened, the three bases are on the same plate. What happens is that the three will move down. And you'll find this plate somewhere here with this reactor, the fourth one here. And then automatically you see the shape. You see the shape of the shimmer, it's a light shimmer, and then you will see the physicality, tangibility according to what field of strength you have created. If you use different kind of GANs inside, if you use homogeneous GANs in all three reactors, all will give you a different kind of material. Tangibility in physicality. So, in respect to the environment, what you're going to get, these three will move down, this top one here will move up, and the 12 rings outside dictates the shielding. So, in so many ways, the plate does not move as such, but the plate is forced to levitate amongst the four reactors. If you go back to our original teaching, when we had, if I can place it on the side that you can see, if we had the three base reactors in this shape, let's use the orange for the base, if you had the three base reactors and we had the top core here, we had somewhere in the middle the free plasma. The free plasma was sitting somewhere here. But now, with this plate being in the position it is, the free plasma moves within the structure of the plate according to the strength of the all the gravitational magnetic fields. So, your free plasma condition is dictated by the totality of the 12 cores, plus the 6 in gravitational. You move it up and up. Where you move this free plasma dictates on the height, the width of your reactor. If you push this higher, so the expansion moves further. So you get a bigger diameter. You don't need to keep on changing your reactor core to get the higher dimension. So your plasma is here, your core is here. If your center core here in the middle, if your center core here, center plate here, creates a field force which is stronger, that it pushes the top core away, higher dimension, you'll see your bases move out. So, the size of your field increases. So, the size of your craft increases. You dictate the size of the craft, and if you control it correctly, you size, decide the size of the shielding, where your shield's gonna be. If you come closer, if you look at it this way, or if you push it that way. So if you look at it the sideways, side view, if you put it on its side, and you have your three reactors based here at 120 degrees, if you can see it. So what happens is that this is your top core, if I can come more in the picture. This is your top core, and your free plasma is somewhere here. Here, if you look at it that way. If we create a certain field here that you push the free plasma further out, so the height increases, the dimension of your craft increases. You control the structure size, but not keep on moving your cores. You decide on the structure size by field control within the structure of the gravitational and magnetical.
Mr. Keshe, Patrick had asked, does this take several days? And I guess in...
Instantaneous.
Right, so...
But in some... You have to understand, the work of your fields.
But wouldn't it be true that in some reactor combinations, it might take time to build up?
No. No, instantaneous. It's instantaneous. Because we see this, you will see it. Because now you have received the... You have to go back on the teaching of this morning. I have given you all the indications and all the teaching you need to know. You have everything. You have... yesterday when we were talking, it was the same position. When I explained and understood, it's just a walkthrough. It's, you got to be able to understand whatever you've done from the beginning in totality. Some of you will achieve... you'll achieve the formation of the craft by accident. But then you'll see half of it, you'll see one half doesn't exist. Because your field forces on one side are weaker, on one side are stronger. And then you will see you create half crafts, you see shimmers. It won't happen, but if any of you are lucky, you'll create the full craft in one go. It goes back to all the teachings from the beginning. You had the free plasma. Now, the height of the free plasma, if you look at it, dictates the size of your craft. If you push it very high, it's just like a tent. The further it goes, the further the other three in the base here, somewhere here, have to find their position. So, instead of being at this position, then when you change it, they move further out. As they move further out, so your magnetical gets bigger. So the tent gets bigger. You will see the next few weeks and months, we will see how we progress now that we're going down the hill and stuff up the hill. Up to now we moved all the way to create a GANS, now we're going down the hill to create matter, or at least physicality of matter.